Why does software only seem to get bigger? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for AskLeo.com. It's a common question. Why does most software get bigger and bigger as time goes by with each version? Like I said, it's a common question. It's a common complaint. What I can tell you is that it's not likely to change. And I can also tell you that a lot of people are not going to like my answer. And they're going to end up claiming various conspiracies. The bottom line, though, is that when software doesn't change, it dies. It's mostly about competition. If you've got a couple of competing products, and all of the products that I know of right now are competing with something, they need to change. They need to add features. They need to do more in order to have another checkbox on the box or whatever. In that sense, it's not necessarily about keeping existing customers happy. It's about keeping new customers or enticing new customers to buy or upgrade to the new version of the product. Unfortunately, when you add features, you add code. Very slowly, things do end up getting bigger. Now, it's true that companies rarely remove code or features. Yes, Windows 11 has removed some features we care about, but in terms of actual, you know, the size of whatever it is they've removed, it's not huge by any stretch. It's negligible, would be my sense. But by and large, software only gets bigger, mostly because software has to compete. It's not about you. Companies that don't continue to improve their products with features and functionality eventually die away. Might take a long time, but they eventually die away. And sadly, stability, as much as we would love more stability, fewer bugs, that's not a feature. It's not something that can be sold. People buying operating systems or other packages don't buy because the box says, now with fewer bugs. That's not what they're doing. They're buying it because it solves a problem they're trying to solve. And yes, they may choose not to buy it because it's unstable. There is definitely a minimum level of stability that is required for a product to be successful, but it's not 100%. There are always going to be problems. And companies have to decide whether to spend precious resources fixing that bug or adding that feature. And adding that feature, unless the bug is serious, adding that feature is likely going to win and likely going to make the product bigger. Interestingly enough, one of the other things that really impacts this is that software developers are always developing for today's machines. If you've got a machine that's, say, 5 years old, it probably has a somewhat slower processor, probably somewhat less RAM, probably somewhat smaller hard drive than a machine that can be purchased new today. The assumptions that the developers are going to make are going to be about today's machine. Some may pick a point in the past, but it's not so far back that it's going to make a lot of older machines happy. The bottom line is that they're developing for today's machines because that's the newest they have available, and they want their software to work well far into the future. And that means making the assumptions about the hardware they have available today. One of the comments I get is that, well, it's just because developers are lazy. Trust me on this. I have been there. I have been one of the people making the sausage. I have been one of the people asking for a delay simply to resolve more issues in my product and having that request be denied. It's a business trade-off. I get it. Don't like it. I'd love for things to be more stable. And in that case, I really would have loved for that product to be more stable. But the bottom line here is that the developers are very, very vested in what they're producing, and they don't like it any more than you do. They do understand the trade-offs, But they absolutely don't like shipping things that fail. In no way are they lazy. They're working their butts off. The last one, it's not a conspiracy. A lot of people seem to think that we're making software bigger and bigger so that we're forcing people to buy new machines. It's not the case. There's plenty of reasons that software gets bigger and bigger. Some magic conspiracy to force you to buy new hardware isn't one of them. The fact is, you don't have to buy a new machine. There are so many alternatives to whatever that software supposedly requires. You can switch operating systems, keep using your old versions. There are people today still using Windows XP, which has been dead for a long time. They didn't have to change a thing, and they, presumably, are happy. And let's face it, if there were such a conspiracy, it would be pretty huge, and somebody would have spilled the beans. Again, that's not what happens. I'm not saying software vendors are always right, and I'm not saying that they're always drawing the stability and feature line in the correct place. I'm actually not even saying that all software developers aren't lazy. I'm sure there are a few. I'm not even saying that the companies always have your best interest at heart. But by and large, most of them are simply trying to compete. Most of the developers are simply trying to make the best product their company will allow them to make. And there are trade-offs along the way. Size happens to be one of them. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic, and I'm sure some entertaining comments, visit askleo.com/13474. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.